Welcome, guys. This is GZTV, and this is God of War Ragnarok, episode 8. Yes, I'm on episode 8, and it's getting harder and harder as it goes. And I feel like my character is not getting strong enough.
I suppose this means you didn't get to Tyr. Sorry, brother.
Definitely mean Tyr beat me up.
A master fights not only to survive, but to grow every encounter.
Fresh rewards with a side of new opportunities.
Nice. Give me that. Do I got new stuff? No.
Only true opponent in Valhalla is yourself.
Facts.
No shame in making things a wee bit easier if you can.
So I could go inside those doors? What is this again? Reroll tokens let you refresh Glenth rules. See new options. Reroll token. I still don't know what this is. I got a lot of spirit seals and all that good stuff. Resources, master seal. Broaden chances of obtaining master seals from breakable pots. Definitely a must. And this, earn a moderate amount of additional spirit seals and mastery when defeating the Lost Chosen. That too, and I'm broke already, and it's like the prices just keep going up.
Valhalla selects your opponents for a reason. Embrace the challenge, but know you
Talisman
can
of Main grant bonus to any damage for a short duration. Yeah, I could use that. Glaive of the Dark. Okay. So the second, okay, I tried that already. Okay. For a short period. I could do that.
Milady, how is Alfheim these days? Does the peace hold?
It's tenuous, but holding. Endless war tends to breed quite a bit of mistrust. Thankfully, the elves, Bela and Bigvir, are in positions of influence. Due to their association with Freyr and involvement in Ragnarok, it's the best chance at lasting peace the realm has ever had.
What about the findings in the Consul's journal? Have they shared it with the rest of the elves?
Not yet, but give them time.
I gotta stop messing around and kick some butt. Evasive blades. I think I know what this is. While evading, hold forward and perform.
A flute?
A flute.
Will you play a song, brother?
It was my daughter's. But I will tell you of it later.
Behind you, brother! Nicely done.
Swift evasion gains a burst of speed and travel within distance. I could definitely use that. What do you have in here? Flames Vanquish. Fireball.
Before you ask, yes, I was back in the old forest again. And this time I encountered my former boss, King Oberon. Rather eye-opening, actually. I used to be a true believer for him. Would have done anything he asked. Now I see through all that charisma and feigned wisdom down to the small, hypocritical tyrant I know him to be. Wait till I tell you what he put me up to regarding a particular magical flower.
Return to here. Return to here. Like I could just go back outside the door. Why did he never let me go down here? Did I just come from down here?
A little boost this time around, maybe.
Take a different route this time.
Above you!
to tell a story of your first master.
Aye. Seems to be the very story Valhalla has me reliving, in fact. Oberon fancied himself a romantic, you see. Always claimed that love was more important to him than anything. One time, he led his entire entourage on a journey to attend the wedding of some duke or other, near your old neck of the woods. The groom, this lordly prick, had conquered a warrior queen.
This conversation will have to wait.
No, no, focus, of course.
What the heck? I'm about to freaking die.
We should be free to move up to the next area now. Huh.
Kratos first melee attack immediately after evading doesn't does increase damage. Yeah, why not?
The flute you found. You said it belonged to your daughter.
I carved it for her as a gift. Playing and was skilled with it. It was a song she played, one I used to remember every note of, but no longer.
Brother, if you mean to recount the story of the day you were tricked into killing your wife and daughter, you don't have to. You've told that story before. We know how it ends. You needn't relive it. That's not the story her flute brings to mind, is it?
No.
Seem within reach, you ask me.
Ring out enemies.
Thank you.
Helios has returned.
Spartan Rage. Fury's attack and exit rage costs greatly reduced, but healing while in Fury also reduced. No, I can't do that.
Watching you think? What a thrill.
Last second dodge. Empower Kratos' next attack to inflict additional damage. Master of Arms. Increase the damage of all Kratos' weapons.
Did you go? I guess the taste is a factor here.
Still a monster, I see.
Gotta make sure my strength is up. Zack had a chance of critical strike during creating an explosion.
Oh, isn't that a shame?
starting over. It's that first boss, man. That first boss beat the crap out of me.
I suppose this means you didn't get to Tyr. Sorry, brother.
Valhalla sees your progress.
Nice.
Shield Maiden.
A blessing. What are obstacles but opportunities for growth?
Ha! A chance to bargain with Valhalla itself. That'll be worth it.
You know the crazy part? I'll be forgetting I can build my stats.
Valhalla has chosen for you to target will only continue to manifest. You must adapt and employ all available resources, or you will fall again.
Sigrun, been wondering, are the remaining Vanir and Aesir playing nice in Vanaheim?
The Asgardian relocation hasn't exactly been smooth sailing. But Hildisvini and Lady Sif are keeping the ship headed in the right direction. The people seem to understand compromise is their best path to prosperity, at least.
Truth be told, I was hoping the old boar would have to call on me to smooth things over. But it's good to hear he and Sif have it under control.
Freya hopes they'll join the council once the peace settles.
Hope you guys is bearing with me. I can do it. Have faith in me.
up his feet again. Still on your mind, brother?
Yes. I will explain later.
Prolonged affliction. Increase the duration of all status applied to the enemy by 50%. Increase all stun damage conflicted.
As I was saying about my old master and his lofty, so-called romantic ideals, we'd settled in a forest outside of Athens, a place well situated to observing the comings and goings of the Duke's other guests. There we observed the romantic complications of some local youths, and Oberon gets it into his head to intervene, bids me fetch him a magical flower that can manipulate the affections of others. Supposedly, the idea was to nobly help true love prevail over the pressure of family arrangements. But what he really wanted was to use the flower to...
We will speak later.
Not offended. Brother, while I'd love to say I left Oberon's service as a matter of principle, the truth is, it was much more a question of pride. If he'd simply shown me more appreciation, who knows how long I might have tolerated his evils. I certainly tolerated plenty from my subsequent employers before I could take no more. If I'm being honest, I was only too happy to offer my complicity in Queen Titania's humiliation.
What did you do?
I caused her to fall in love with something preposterous. An actor.
Behind you, brother!
supply, temporarily, by use of this magic flower. Though now it's clear to me the flower's effect isn't love, exactly, but a kind of obsessive devotion that is too often mistaken for love. So, of course, the Queen made a fool of herself, as did all those under the flower's spell that night. Don't know how I ever got embroiled in such a farce.
You are wiser now.
I think so. Though that only makes up for so much past stupidity.
Let's see what we got.
I believe your target's on the battlefield there.
Beating the smokes out of me.
Sorry, brother. That dauber was especially challenging. Keep on.
The resilient warrior dances with change, easily adjusting to its rhythm. Perfection may be unattainable, but in magic...
It's never been easier to be better.
Magic. Ruin it. A little bit of luck.
Don't let Valhalla's chosen opponents get into your head, or else you'll fall to them again.
Sigrun has been important to you for as long as I have known you. What happened in the beginning?
Oh, it's a typical enough story. A boy meets girl, girl fulfills her ambition to transcend the physical plane and become a Valkyrie of Valhalla. One day, Sigrun quietly arrived from Fjordalund and began serving as Freya's handmaiden while she undertook training for the Sisterhood. I don't even think we were introduced. I just see her around the court. Of course, I observed her loveliness and impressive stature, but long before we fell to talking. But we seem cut from different cloth, I suppose.
One moment.
Sigrun, how was it you first spoke?
Back when Freya was queen in Asgard, the better times, I mean, there really began to be some culture around the place. Poets, musicians, the odd contortionist would pay visits, perform, mingle. On one occasion, I'd taken a seat expecting to see this balladeer of the lowlands when Sigrun walked in. Somehow more stunning than I'd ever seen her. And when of all places she chose to sit next to me, well,
come here. I must concentrate.
Do what you need.
Brother, I see the one you need to get there.
Behind you, brother!
That'll be the end of episode 8. I'll tell you what will happen in the next episode. Will I defeat these never-ending trials? Will I keep getting killed? Will I ever beat these trials? Well, we'll see in the next episode, in episode 9. So stay tuned, tap in, make sure you like, share, subscribe, hit the notification button so you can get all my videos as they come out. All right, guys. Later.